Hey all, welcome to Share Trek. This is Raj here. Friends, I would first like to thank all the Patreons and the members who attended the members-only Zoom call with Jeff Galvin today to hear Jeff Galvin speak and also to ask Jeff Galvin their questions. So thank you very much for the support. And I'm going to be making a short video, rapid-fire video, with the questions that Jeff Galvin was asked by our members. And Jeff Galvin will answer those questions very concisely in 1 minute, and that will be available to everybody in the channel. So it will be a public video. So please look forward to that. Check, press the notify button so that you can be notified as soon as it is released. So that said, the big question you guys are all asking is what happened to Excision Bio's EBT101? There have been press reports that it has not been successful. So I would like to address that in this particular video. So let's get started. Welcome back, friends. So we had a report from Excision Bio saying that they had dosed 3 patients in phase 1 clinical trial. 2 of them showed viral rebound within 3 to 4 weeks. And one of them showed viral rebound after, I think, 16 weeks or something like that, a prolonged period of time. So Excision Bio thinks that the one that showed prolonged period of suppression of HIV indicates that the therapy has got promise. It's a positive indication, but the other two seem to indicate that something went wrong and it didn't work the way it was supposed to work. So now if we go back to how Excision Bio works, Excision Bio's EBT101 works, it's basically an adeno-associated virus which is loaded with 2 guide RNAs and a CRISPR-Cas9 molecule so that it can go and hunt for HIV-infected cells in the body and cut it into 3 pieces, thereby doing an excision of a very critical portion of HIV genome so that the HIV virus, which is embedded in the human genome, is not able to produce new copies and effectively neutering it. So that's the approach it is taken. And the press release, now keeping that in mind, remember, the press release said that, further said that they are going to go back to work on a new delivery mechanism or a new vector to deliver the therapy. Now, based on all these things, I have drawn some conclusions. So first, let me share some extra information that I have with me based on my readings before I give my conclusions. It's reported widely that adeno-associated virus are present predominantly in humans, and therefore there are many strains of AAV to which our human body is immune, which means as soon as they enter the body, they get neutralized. Therefore, AAVs from animal sources are used because they are foreign to the human body, and therefore they would be able to deliver their payload before they get neutralized. So please keep that factor in mind. So I think that the fact that Excision says that the patient who had viral suppression for 16 weeks indicates that the therapy works. I agree with them on that aspect. And the second statement that they are going back to the lab to work on a new vector for delivery of the therapy seems to indicate to me that they suspect that the AAV got neutralized and therefore the gene editing payload was not delivered. And so the viral rebound happened immediately for 2 patients. So if it happened for 2 out of 3 patients, that means the delivery vector has to be changed for it to be effective. So friends, I don't think this is a very big setback. I think they can go back and find a suitable delivery mechanism in order to make sure that it gets delivered to all the tissues. Now there is another interesting paper from Excision Bio that I dug up from 2020, I think it was Nature magazine, where they had disclosed that they had dosed 3 primates, and all 3 primates showed really good evidence of excision of HIV virus from their infected cells. So that was one point they mentioned there. And the other point that caught my mind was the fact that they said that the CRISPR-Cas9 payload was also found on macrophages in the brain of these non-human primates. So that indicates to me that the strain of AAV used by Excision Bio was able to cross the blood-brain barrier and target macrophages in the brain as well if it was infected with HIV. So I'm thinking that EBT101 is still going to be a success. All they need to do is to get a new vector in which they can load the gene editing payload and the targets and send it into the body. So I'm rooting for Excision Bio, EBT101. I think they will eventually succeed. So that's the point I would like to make. There's another point I would like to make. I think that they may have to do multiple dosing of EBT101 to the patient. Therefore, the reason why I think they will have to do that is because when a patient is on ART, the viral loads are suppressed and Excision can go and start killing all the active HIV cells which are producing the virions. But if it has to target the hidden reservoirs, then it has to do another phase of treatment with AAV after using a kick start agent which can activate dormant HIV cells to start replicating HIV virions so that they can be seen by EBT101, and then EBT101 will go in there and knock it out. Therefore, if this therapy might need multiple stages to deliver, then I think they would have to use multiple vectors, a vector for the first delivery, a vector for the second delivery, and so on. This is how, as a layperson with a little bit of reading, I think they may have to design their therapy. So even though they have gone back to the drawing board, I think all is good with EBT101. This is just a little bit of a setback. It's not a failure. So I look forward to see more press releases from EBT101 on their strategy, what viral strain they are using. And I wish the Excision team the very best. I think they will succeed. So friends, take heart. I think all is not lost. EBT101 will come back in a new avatar with the same gene editing payload and the same targets, but a different vector. And that vector, I think, will be multiple different vectors so that they can have phased approach. The first phase will be to kill all the known reservoir which is active. And then the second phase will be to use a kick agent to awaken all the dormant HIV. And then induce Excision EBT101 in order to kill all those cells. So it's going to be multi-step treatment. So probably two different vectors for two different doses. That's the way I visualize it. You guys can put your comments below so that I can understand how you look at this. So this is my interpretation of what happened with Excision Bio's EBT101. So friends, if you've already been a subscriber, support the channel by becoming a member or a Patreon. The link is in the description, and I look forward to your continued support to the channel. Thanks and have a great day. I'll catch up with you again in the next video.